Hi. One of the complex activities in the object detection pipeline is collecting data and then creating ground truth tables for that data. When I say ground truth tables, you have bounding boxes for different objects that you're planning to detect, right? So that is one of the complex activities. In this video, we are going to see how we can collect the data, create bounding boxes for the collected data, all in within Colab. So we will not be moving outside of Colab. We will be done everything within Colab. So let's get started. The very first thing for collecting data, I'm going to use a package for Google image search. And that is the package is your Google image download. You can do a pip install from his GitHub repo over here to install this particular package. I have already installed it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to import this particular package, Google image download. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just initializing the Google image download package by calling again Google images download, which is assigned to a response variable. So now once I have it, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell this particular package what keyword in Google images I need to search for. So I'm going to search for alone polar bear in Arctic circle, right? In Arctic. So I want only one image of polar bear, but it's not guaranteed. Again, the search may not be perfect. You may get multiple, but I will as far as possible, I want just one polar bear that I want to label. And I'm telling like the limit is six, only get me six images. You can download a lot of images and you can label it. But for this demo, I just want to download six images. Format JPEG and print the URLs as you are downloading. So it will just the kind of a verbose it will show in the command. And then I'm calling this response object that I created dot download, and I'm passing the arguments on the top. So what happens once I run this, it will go and hit the Google image search and it will start downloading the images. If you see over here, this is kind of downloading all the images. It has downloaded six images. And if you go to by default, it will download the image in the downloads directory. And what I'm doing is I'm doing ls download, and the search criteria that I given will be created as a folder. So alone polar bear in Arctic will be a folder. Once I click on that, you can see these are the six images that it has downloaded. Now next, what I'm going to do is I need something to do and create ground truth table for objects, because for object detection, I need to know the x coordinate, y coordinate with the height of that particular object. I need kind of an bounding boxes for the objects I want to detect. So for that, what I'm doing is I'm cloning the package called TensorFlow models, right? Now the TensorFlow models provide something called Colab utils. So basically it has a lot of object detection utilities. And one of the things that it provides is Colab utils, which has an object detection kind of a window where you can see all the images and then draw bounding box of it. I'll show you how it is. So I'm just cloning this object, and I'm going within this downloaded clone repository in my local. I'm going to the object detection package tf2 setup file, and I'm doing an install over there. I have done this both the step. It's going to take some time, but once you run these two, the TensorFlow models will be installed in your local local environment, right? After that, what I'm going to do is these two steps I have executed already. So in case if you are doing it, just execute these two steps. After that, I am importing some of the packages to pre-process the image, and then also to kind of draw a bounding box on the image, right? So these are some of the packages that I'm importing. Pill is for processing the image. Bytes.io is for like reading the image. Then what I'm doing is these two packages comes with the install that we did on the top. It comes within the TensorFlow model setup.py that we ran. These two comes in that we have two utilities. One is Colab utils, which is used for drawing bounding boxes. Visualization utils, which is used for visualizing the bounding box. These two things I am importing, and I am importing matplotlib just to visualize it. Right. So once it's done, the very first thing I'm going to do is the six images that I downloaded, those are in typical file system, right? JPEG file. I need to convert that into a NumPy array object. So for that, I am creating a function load image into NumPy array, and this will take each image as input, and then it's going to kind of convert that. It's going to return a NumPy array of it. So it's taking each input as image, and then it is basically doing that image.open bytes.io image data. It is taking the image height and width and then converting that into a NumPy array. So let me run this. And then next, what I am doing is basically I am configuring the folder where I downloaded it. So it's in content downloads, alone porag and artic. And then I'm creating an NumPy array object. I'm creating a array object rather. And then I am iterating to this particular image path, image by image. And then I'm calling the load image into NumPy and then appending it in the top list I have created. So all the objects will be converted into a NumPy array. So I'm going to run this. Okay, so I forgot to import TensorFlow. Let me quickly do that. Import TensorFlow as TF. The reason is I'm using like a tf.io g file command, which will process the file. So that's why the TensorFlow is required. Now let me quickly run this. So this will, you can see like, okay, this is running now. It's going to create everything into a NumPy array object. It has converted it. I can quickly, what I can do is I can use matplotlib to iterate through the NumPy array. I'm just passing this polar images np, which is my list object I created. I'm going to read one by one NumPy array of the image, and I'm just going to display the images that are downloaded. All right. So these are the different images that are downloaded. Right, there is a polar bear here, and you can see in this image, maybe once you go to the full screen, you can see there's a small polar bear here, right? So once you are running, you may want to run it for 100 or 200 images. Here there are only 6 images. So now you have the images. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw bounding boxes for it. So I'm just initializing a list object, and then I'm calling the collabutils that I imported, the collabutils.annotate. And I'm passing the NumPy array of all the images, that is the polar NP, image NP that I created on the top. And then I'm telling the bounding boxes that I'm creating, store it in the GT underscore boxes that I have assigned in the top. So basically the X, Y coordinate that we are generating, that will get stored in the GT boxes object. So let me run this quickly. And now you can see basically it has kind of it's showing the image, right? So one thing you can do is just to see full screen, you can click here, and then you can click on the top in your collab, and you can say like this particular cell I want to view output full screen. Once you do that, it will come in a separate screen. Now if you're seeing this image, what you can do is to draw a bounding box. You can basically click over here, and then you can select that particular bounding box for the polar bear. Once you select it, you can just go to next image, and you will keep getting like, I have only 6 images, so I can do this, and this is the next image. Then let me, if you do here, you can see the polar bear is pretty small in this image. So I'm going to select here next image, and then this is again a polar bear. Okay, so in case you do a mistake, you can just go and do an undo bounding box, and you can click, and you can select again. Okay, you can just a minute. Yeah. So this is again this one, and then let me go, and then I think I have the final one now. This one, I'm not sure there is more of it. So this, and then next image, there's one more. Yeah. So next image, that's it, says all image completed. Now I can press escape to go back to my window. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to say submit. And it says that boxes arrays are populated. Now it's going to populate. If you see the output, I have given GT underscore boxes. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to print all the GT underscore boxes. And you can see like basically this for 6 images, the bounding boxes are created over here. This bounding box is in a format that TensorFlow models can accept. If you want to change it into a YOLO format, or if you want to change it in an XML format like Pascal VOC or Cocoa format, you can go to GitHub. There are a lot of GitHub repos available that can take this format and convert into a different format. But if you're running in TensorFlow, you can just use it directly. Now I have this for bounding boxes, just that I don't want to lose it after this session. I can just say np.save weights of GT boxes. So basically it will save this particular GT boxes in the weights file. So it will save it as a npy file. So once I save it in my local, you can see that's a weights.npy file, right? So it has saved it over there. Now to visualize the bounding box, I have to see how the bounding box has done properly. So here what I'm going to do is I'm going to iterate through this particular images. I know there are six images. I'm going to iterate it, and I'm using this visualization utils that also comes part of the TensorFlow models that we installed, right? And then I'm going to kind of iterate through this. I'm going to pass the each and every polar bear image, and then I am going to pass the bounding box that I created for that. So basically, if you see in this, I am passing the index, and in this I am passing the index. So first image, I am getting the first bounding box, and then I am just doing a plot.image show. Like that, it will iterate for each image, and it will show the bounding. It will show the pictures with the bounding box. If you see over here, this is a polar bear with the bounding box. This is a polar bear with the bounding box. So you can see like everything is. For each of these, you have bounding box. Now you can collect for more images and go and train an object detection model. Now this particular object detection, object labeling utility, right? Like image labeling utility, it's not very robust. It can do only for one images. But if you have multiple objects within an image and you want to label it, you can go for like there's a tool called Label Image, which is available in GitHub repo. You can just download and install it in your local and do it. But if you want to do it within Colab, and if you want to only label one image in an one object in an image, there's a pretty nice utility that you can use. Thank you very much.